Amen. And tonight, you're gonna end 2017 on a lovely note, on a powerful note, such that you experience the transformation of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I believe that the Lord will visit you even in your last minute. Hallelujah. He visited Abraham. He visited Sarah. When these guys were in their last minute of life. Hallelujah. He transformed their lives. He visited Zachariah and Elizabeth. When they lost hope that they will have no child. Whatever you have needed for 2017, before it is 00, but to 59, you will have them.
Amen.
Ah, listen, God to me. That door, which seemed to be difficult to open, by 2359, that door will open.
The same God who empowered Peter and went
effectively for him to the ministry of the Jews. Also worked effectively for me and empowered me in my ministry to the Gentiles. I don't know whatever empowerment you come for, but everybody has come for their own. Isn't it? Some will be empowered for business. Some will be empowered for employment. Some will be empowered for building. Some will be empowered for whatever they're going to be empowered. If it's healing, whatever empowerment I'll give you, the Lord will give it to you. But before we go out of this place, you shall carry your own.
Hallelujah.
You shall carry what? Your own.
Yes.
So in any area you are, you just tell God you are the same God who worked in Elijah. You are the same God within me.
Yes.
The same God who empowered them will empower me.
Yes.
Last time I came and I said we admire people of old days, believing that they had more powerful God than us today.
Yes.
But it is biblical and spiritual that every generation must discover God for themselves.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So now Paul says the same God in them was the same God in me. The only difference is that me and that God, we have history.
Yes.
We have walked in the journey. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So when we begin to worship, forget about your neighbor came for your own empowerment.
Yes.
You have also come for your own.
Yes.
Peter was for the Jews.
Yes.
Paul was for the Gentiles. Maybe you are for the blacks. Your neighbor is for the Indian. It is empowerment, you see. Whether yours is for the Chinese and your friend is for the Asian, it's still empowered.
Yes.
So you carry your own tonight. I feel in my spirit there is no preaching, there is no nothing. It's just going to be worship. Why? The same God who released the empowerment shall release it tonight.
Yes.
The same God who worked wonders in their lives shall work in you.
Yeah.
You are allowed to worship God in any way. If you want to lie down, you're going to lie down. If you want to jump, you're going to jump. If you want to do whatever you want to do, you do it. Hallelujah. Yeah. But I came for myself. The same God who raised Lazarus must resurrect some things in me.
Yeah.
When I came in the morning, I said, the power on you is not enough. You need power in you.
Yes.
In 2018, I need power in me. Why? Because when I've got power on me, Jesus said, is to preach for the gospel, to heal the sick, to command the prison to be broken, and shake the foundation of darkness. That is the power on me. It's good. But now I need something for myself. You know you can have power to pray for your neighbor, and don't have power to pray for yourself. It is very interesting how you can have power to encourage somebody else and not have power to encourage yourself. But tonight we're going to have power for ourselves, the inside. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead dwell in me. So without any music, without any song, just where you are, lift your voice. Everybody's on something in their spirit. Just lift up your voice and begin to praise God in any language, in any form.
Thank you.
who shall do it in me? The same God who did it in the life of Elijah is the same God who shall do it in my life. I am not saying God of Elijah, come down. I'm saying the same God who was in Elijah, the same God who was in Paul, the same God who was in Mary, the same God who loosed Lazarus.
Thank you. of the blood. Change. If I can touch, just touch, just touch, just touch. If I can just touch, if I can just touch, even if I don't know it, but if I can just touch it, even if I'm not brought to it, but if I can just touch it, if I can just touch it, if I can just touch.
Thank you. With impartation. If you're gonna cry, you cry. If you're You shall step on the ground. It was a command. Any land your feet shall touch, you shall possess it. It was not a prayer point, it was a command. Right now, take that command and walk in it. Tell the Lord, as I walk around this church, I take the position of the command.
Fire! Break your chair! Also, I got a punch, put up!
sitting the chair on your head. Therefore, I'm going to church for now. We get power today. That you should do challenge that in the morning, man. Charlie was a punch. That evil hand of the devil that was placed on you, that anytime he wants to be arising, it pull you down. I want you to face that hand. Any glass on your chest, any glass on your forehead, any glass on your head.
Once the power of the appeal, you're the sense of a shapia. Once the battery of the battery.
down and sit on it.
Jesus, we cancel death, we cancel sickness in Jesus' name. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, congratulations for seeing me in 2018. You are lucky you have seen my face, you are blessed to see me first. Congratulations for seeing my face first. And we have declared that from January to December, if anything will not happen, then what is going to happen is the purpose of the Lord. Something and it not work, then get ready for the purpose of the Lord. Because the Bible says man can plan, but only the purpose of the Lord shall prevail. My purpose and my plan did not work, then I'll not be crying. Then I know that on that day, 1st January, we declared, if it never came to pass that which I planned for, then there is a sound from heaven that is about to come my way. Because nothing else can prevail apart from the purpose of the Lord. Tell your neighbor, only the purpose of the Lord, my friend, shall prevail over my plans. In the name of Jesus. There is nothing like know the devil this, know the devil that, know the devil this. In 2018, we shall say, the Lord gives, the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So forget about the devil. There is nothing like, oh, the devil has been hurting my finances. Nothing. If you want to get employed in whatever you apply for, then the purpose of the Lord shall prevail.
Yes.
If your plan has not come to fulfillment, then the purpose of the Lord shall prevail. That's the last prayer point we are going to pray. That Lord, in 2018, nothing else but your will, nothing else but your purpose. If what I plan does not work, let your will prevail. You see, one day God said to me, you can know my purpose and have a personality contrary to my purpose. So pray that, Lord, align my personality with your will for my life. Those are prayer points we pray in the church. Not just binding witches. You're going to pray, Lord, assign me. Align me, my mind, my attitude, my thoughts with your will for my life. If I won't stop it, then you're going to deliver me from myself. Open your mouth and pray. Pray. This year, I will never live below the mark. Whatever mission you have mentioned for me, in prayer points, in fasting, in studying the word, align my will and my purpose for that. Pray and you are praying, come and get your shoes. Shoes, put your shoes on. As I'm putting on my shoes, I'm aligning myself with the purpose of the Lord for my life. As I'm praying, putting on my shoes, I'm aligning myself with the intention of God. You said before I was in my mother's womb, you knew me. You had a plan for me. Father, whatever plan you have for me, that's a plan I desire for my life. Whatever your intention is for my life, that is what is my intention. Whatever you intend for me, that's what I say yes. Because you are my God. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You can take your seats. In Jesus' name. If your neighbor is not smiling, tell your neighbor to take that face in 2017. Hallelujah. Before I come down from this pulpit, because I'm going somewhere, I'm going to be preaching and praying, and I can see time is running. So in closing, I'm waiting for those who are moving to stop, and those who are talking to stop. At least if we finish 12 by check, we will do a push up on fireworks. Shut up, got a fireworks for pastor. To push it on. Much. Once a while, I will talk. Anyway, it has been wonderful and nice to have a fellowship in this church. I've told you that I'm not a visitor myself. So no introduction.
No need for me to introduce myself. So I want to say thank you to Pastor Vincent Chiwesa and his wonderful wife and his powerful leadership team for hours and hours. But today, you are here as well. So we pray for you in advance.
Amen.
So sir, we thank you very much for your invitation. I believe my wife would be very glad to be here with me, but she's gone. But I just want to say thank you for the invitation, for the conference that you invited us. And it was a privilege to be the first speaker of the conference. Yeah. I love every one of you here. Me, I'm the only one who won't tell you I love you by force. Because if you don't love me, God won't change his mind. He's going to bless me whether you like me or not. So you just have to like me. Because that one won't change. So I bless you. 2018, we have already prayed.
Yes.
There is nothing like declaration. Mm-hmm. We enter 2018 during the conference. And I believe each one of you got an abortion.
Yeah.
We preached about vessels. Pastors preached about faith. Other men of God preached about so many things. But I believe in my spirit that this has become a large house. And next time I'll visit this church, it will be a large. And I say it, that you can become whatever you want. We can undo you. Baby, I never talk one shy way. What if you are a businessman to rap one shy? We're in a large house and we're in 2018. So for the leadership of this church, we say thank you, God bless you. And any time I'll come in Zambia, it will be my joy to be here. You know, it's always wonderful when you come to the church where they sing real music, real worship, proper songs. It is always wonderful. So thank you very much. God bless you. Thank you.
year. Hallelujah. We left home yesterday, last year. We are going home this year. I'm not going to enter that house the same. I'm going to face this new way. A different person, different views, different perception. Watch my space if you don't want to move. Hallelujah. That's why. Thank you.
Okay. 2018 is my year of new beginnings, fruitfulness, and what? Leaders and motivation.
Establishment.
2018, my year of new beginnings, fruitfulness, and establishment. I was excited when he was leading us in prayers. He talked about establishment. Amen. Establishment. So I want you to know that that's the prophetic word we are going to move with. Now everything that we have for the year, you have to understand that that is the prophetic word you have to run with. Are we all able to get English? Play of wisdom, was it? Hello? Hey! Dripo!
Amen!
So, whenever we have a theme for that particular year, it is also referred to as a prophetic word. So the prophetic word for your person of faith is a year of new beginnings, fruitfulness, and establishment. Now we have to experience, according to what God has said, we should be in that particular year. Amen. I was sharing with the leaders, telling them how that we've seen the divine favor of God, the extraordinary divine favor of God in the year 2017. That is the way we were running with. But I believe now this time, it is the time to experience new things in the ministry. Not the things that you've seen in the past. These are new things that we are going to see. And these are things that you've never seen, we have never experienced, just like we have experienced today. Amen. And so let's turn our Bibles. I'll share briefly on this. To Micah chapter number 4, verses 1 to 4. Mika. Are we around? Are we around?
Amen.
Where is Mika? My Bible doesn't have Mika. Huh? On what page? You know page here? Your maker is on what page?
65.
But we passed 89, but we passed 65.
65.
Huh? In what book?
NIV.
Alright. Micah chapter number 4, verses 1, coming down. The Bible says, but in the last days it shall come to pass that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established in the top of the mountains, and it shall be exalted above the hills. and people shall flow unto it. And many nations shall come and say, come, and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, and to the house of the Lord, or to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his path. For the Lord shall go forth of Zion, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem, and he shall judge among many people, and rebuke strong nations afar off, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up a sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore, but they shall sit every man under his vine and under his fig tree, and none shall make them afraid, for the mouth of the Lord of hosts has spoken it. Hallelujah. Amen. That is going to be our main text for the prophetic word that we have this year. This time we'll have the stickers, but you have to buy them. Amen. You have to put the sticker on your vehicle, on your Bible, on your books, on your door. As you enter your house, you see it. Instead of sticking pictures on the walls, you stick the theme. Amen. Instead of sticking pictures, you stick what? The theme. So that when you turn to the left, to the right, you see that this is my year of new beginnings. This is my year of fruitfulness. This is my year of what? Establishment. Amen. So the passage of scripture that we have read, it is very powerful, but we need to understand. You have to know this passage of scripture by heart. Amen. Why should you know it by heart? It's because this year we will run with this word. Amen. Now, when we talk of new beginnings, of course we are talking of new levels. Amen. When we talk of new beginnings, we are talking of a fresh start to anything in life, in this ministry. Now, this word is not just applying to the church, it's applying to every member, every son and daughter of the ministry. Are we getting the point? So much that the moment you begin to run with this word, then things will come to pass in your life. If you don't run with it, you will not see anything. You will not have the grace to move with the prophetic word that is coming, that has been announced in your life. Amen. So it is very important that every word that comes, we begin to walk with it. So it is a fresh what? Start. In any area of your life, I want to check around your life and how the level of your commitment, the things of God. How has been your level of commitment in the past year? The Lord is saying this year, it is the year that you have to start things afresh. You start things anew. Amen. Because that moment when you make the decision to begin to move in the new beginnings or in the fresh start of anything in your life, that is when you are going to see the reality of what God has packaged for you this year. Amen. Whatever God has packaged for you this year is enshrined in this theme or the prophetic word. So don't say no more that no mwaka, mwaka wandu wa kwamba ichipia chipia feel too. Then you are allowing God to come through in your life. Amen.
Amen.
So before we talk about Micah, let's turn to Isaiah. Let's turn to Isaiah 42, verses 9 to 10. Then we have to read Isaiah 43, verses 18 to 19. Isaiah 42, verses 9 to 10. Elder Melinda, please, you can come quickly and read for us. And the other one should turn to Isaiah 43, 18 to 19.
Let's see. The Bible says, "Behold, the former things have come to pass. Now I declare new things." We just read this again. "Behold, the former things have come to pass. Now I declare new things. Before they spring forth, I proclaim them to you. As then, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing his praises from the end of the earth. You who go down to the sea and all that is in it, you islands and those who dwell on them."
Amen. "Behold, the former things have come to pass." Okay. The other one to read Isaiah 43, verses 18 to 19. Means new beginning. Huh? When we get to this point, because the Lord is saying that, the Lord is saying, "Behold, the former things have come to pass, and the new things I declare." Amen. We are not going to dwell on the anointing of 2017. Hello? We are not going to dwell on the anointing of 2017, because 2017 has gone. This is in the former things. God spoke and things came to pass. But this year, God is saying he's going to declare a new thing. Amen. He's going to declare what? A new thing. Is going to declare a new thing. So the only thing that you and I ought to do is simply to see things, to allow the Spirit of God to open our eyes. Because if you remain blind, you are not going to achieve that which God wants you to achieve this year. Amen. It will just be like it. You get into the water, then you come out the same way. But if you allow the Spirit of God to open the eyes of your understanding, then you begin to understand that which God is declaring in your life, a new thing. Amen. If you used to be a sickling in the year 2017, this year the Lord is saying he is declaring a new thing so that you can sing a new song. Why? He is the one who is putting a new song in us. There is a certain song that you have been singing throughout the year 2017, but the Lord is saying, "No, that is not the song. I'm going to give you what? A new song." That's what the Lord is saying. So all that we need to do is to enter into the match that with God, then we will see that which God wants us to see this year. We already did read, but Prophet William Azor's ministry, he said in closing that many are the plans in the heart of man, but it is the purposes of God which will do what? Will stand. Now, if last year you never grasped what the purposes of God are in your life, it is time that you can also seek counsel, because God wants you to begin on a new note this year. Hallelujah. God wants you to begin on a new note. If people spoke negatively in your life and you paid attention, your emotions were disturbed because of the words which were spoken unto you, this year the Lord is declaring a new thing. Ufiwa kumakuma shiwi ayaba negative in your life. Like how you don't feel in Okyov. Are we getting the point? That will cause us to step into our inheritance. Once we allow the new things that God is declaring, not what man is declaring, not what man is declaring, what God is declaring. Now, what is it that God is able to declare in our lives? In Jeremiah 29, the Bible says that, I know the plans that I have for you. Plans not to harm you, but plans to give you what? A future and a hope, an expected end. That's what the Lord says. So, what things can he declare? What new things can he declare in our lives? He's going to declare only things that are valuable to us. Only things that are good for us. Amen. Those are the things that God is going to declare. He declares that you are the head and not the tail. He declares that you are healed and not sick. He declares that you are blessed and not cursed. That is the declaration of God. He says you are the apple of my eye. But last year, when we speak something in your life, when people say something in your life, you used to take it and sleep with it. That's why when you look at last year, things hadn't been okay. But this year the Lord is saying, I want to declare a new thing in your life. Don't you see it? So that you can sing to the Lord a new song and his praise from the ends of the earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Allow the Spirit of God to operate in your life. If you are to experience a fresh start in your life, if you want to experience new things in your life, fresh anointing in your life, not that if you are in last year, if you are in this year, it's not like that. Even myself, I am saying the way I've been ministering last year, I don't need to remain on that same level. I need to move. Hallelujah. I need the fresh anointing this year, specifically for 2018, so that as I stand, each time that I stand before you, I become relevant. I speak that which God is telling me to bring forth to you. Hallelujah. So I was saying that the number eight, the spiritual meaning of eight is new start. New
start.
Start. Or new beginning. Amen. Now you want to understand that Jesus is the Alpha. Amen. He's the Alpha and Omega. So the same way we started with the Christ, we have to finish with him on the 31st of December of this year. Hallelujah. So God began a new chapter with eight. Yeah? God begins a new chapter in Genesis. In Genesis, when you look at the story of Noah, Genesis chapter number 6, going down to chapter 9, we see that God started a new chapter with the human being, or the man, or mankind here on earth. He said to Noah, Noah, I want you to make an ark. Because at that time, there was so much sin on earth. And then there was only one man. If you read in Genesis chapter number 6, verses 1, you're going to see that Noah found the favor in the eyes of God because of his righteousness. Huh? The Bible says Noah walked before God. Now, because Noah walked before God, the Lord did not want to do what? To kill Noah and the others. Because of Noah, because of his right standing with God, Noah was instructed to create an ark where only him, the wife, his two sons, and what? Huh? And the in-laws. So God began a new chapter with few people. Because he cleared everyone. He said, I want to begin a new chapter with people who are righteous only. How many of us would like to stay with people who are drunkards, with people who are prostitutes? No one likes it. Huh? Now, because sin stinks before God. And so he said, no. We need to start, I need to start new things with man. So what do I do? Let me save these people. After I have saved them, then I can start a new chapter with them because I know these ones, they'll listen to me. So God is able to do great things with only a few people. And is able to give or to bring order. Is able to bring order in any area with only a few people. Amen. So if the few people who are here tonight are able to grasp the word and decide to separate themselves from the things of the enemy, then transformation will become evident here in this community and where you stay. Hallelujah. So the Lord says to this ministry, those you have been, he says, though you have been few in the past years, this time, I, the Lord your God, I am the beginning and the end, the Alpha of all things, will surely grant you increase and establishment in every area of your life and the ministry. Hallelujah. Now, God is saying, because he's beginning with us, he's giving us a new start. He's declaring new things. It means that in our leadership, there's going to be new things. In the preaching, there's going to be new things. In every area of this ministry, be it spiritually, financially, materially, numerically, the Lord says he's declaring a new thing in every area of our lives, in every area of this ministry. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 17, verses 9 to 12. Genesis 17, verses 9 to 12. Now, can we read that one? You guys don't sleep here. If your neighbor is sleeping, my thing never let you look at my name. Genesis 17, verses 9 to 12. Dominic, please help us with that. We are still talking about the new beginning.
This is my covenant which you shall keep between me and you and your descendants after you. Every male among you shall be circumcised, and you shall be circumcised in the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be the sign of the covenant between me and you. Verse 12. And every male among you who is 8 days old shall be circumcised throughout your generation. A servant who is born in the house or who is bought with money from any other foreigner who is not of your descendants.
Hallelujah. On the 8th day, evangelist, I want you to prepare. You're going to come and lead us as we declare a fresh start. Amen. As we declare new beginnings. What's happening? What's happening? So to get started, pray. Then you will share also on this. Now, in Genesis 17, verses 9 to 12, I want you to see one thing there. The number 8. The number 8, that is a time that the children of Israel, the male folk, entered into a covenant. That is the time that people became one with God. I'll be able to explain these things further on Sunday. So 8, it was on the 8th day that every male Israelite entered the new level in their lives by getting into a covenant with God. Now I'll explain what covenant means. Amen. Amen. This is the time that even Jesus, on the 8th day, he was circumcised. That is the time he was also presented in the house of God. That was the time he was dedicated. Because every male Jew has to be circumcised on the 8th day. Namu fisiko. Umana grafia iwa. Bamtari sakshikuna. Shpada. What's mine? Abadwale, when is the first time you take the child to the clinic?
After 7 days.
So that one is taken from the Bible. After 7 days. So it means Mungu pereka day number 8. Swamen, what do they do on day number 8?
They check. If Sarah passed BCG, that's when they give BCG.
Am I Santana? We will tell you now. Oh, but they were not starting BCG. Navina Mubasa. 18 to make sense in your life. If you want 2018 to make sense in your life, understand that to become accessible by God, it's only when I enter into a covenant with Him. Now, at this point, I'd like you to know that the terms of the covenant, like you can read Genesis, the same Genesis 17, verses 1 and 2. What does it say? I'm telling you.
Abraham and said to him, I am.
No. It is still in 17.
17 is
one. No, this is 2. Start from verses 2.
The Bible says, I will establish my covenant between me and you, and I will multiply you exceedingly.
Okay, let me just confirm it. The same Genesis, there's a place where God says, it is your responsibility to keep the terms of the covenant. This is 19. It is in 17. Jesus. Okay, it's the same 17. It says it is your responsibility to keep the terms of the covenant, because in order for the covenant, the terms of the covenant to come to pass, covenant is an agreement that you get into. For example, when we take a man and a woman who are getting married, they now have terms of reference in their marriage. That is why when I say, ukuta mwere yako vane, tabareko iyo. Are we getting the point? Because the terms of the covenant says that I am the head. I am the head. I don't know whether you get it the way I'm saying it, to say. You are responsible. Okay, the version I was reading is on the computer.
And God said to Abraham, as for you, you shall keep a covenant, you and your offspring, after you throughout their generations.
Okay. The New Living Translation says, it is your responsibility to keep the terms of of the covenant. Trumpet. It is what? It is what? To keep the terms of the covenant. So in order for you and I to enjoy what is written in the covenant, we have to abide to it. It is our responsibility, not the responsibility of my partner. Huh? That is why the Bible says, if it is it in your ability, make every effort to be at peace with all. Make every effort to be at peace with all. Hey, I think it will look. People are sleeping. They're not sleeping.
Yes.
Make every effort to be at peace with all men. With all men. Now, it is your responsibility to make things work, not the responsibility of your friend. Huh? But the Bible says that do not grow weary in doing what? In doing what? Don't grow weary in doing it good. Or don't stop doing it what is good. That's what the Bible says. Now, why is it like that? It's because even if the man came away, that's what Jesus says. Love your enemies. Who can love his enemies? No one. But when you have God in you, when you are moving with this covenant keeping God, then you and I are going to love even when we are not loved. Amen. That's why God is saying, it is your responsibility to keep the terms of the covenant. Then it is also my responsibility to fulfill the terms of the covenant. So the moment you begin to live according to the terms of the covenant, you are going to become unstoppable. You are going to become undeniable. God will take over your life. Are we getting that? The moment twamba ukwendera muma terms or mufinje felesa alanda fetwa yendera mo. For example, the salam dokwevati do not neglect the assembling of one another. Mwileka okumana cha pamo. Ngefyo wambi bachita. Tawafa okumana ipawana wachani bakumene. Are you getting the point? Now that is a term of the covenant. So if you don't do that, if you miss church, then you are missing what? The point. You are missing, you are not keeping the terms of the covenant. Huh?
Amen.
You shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. But you know my son, I'm okay, but me, I hate that person naturally. You are so the chapter, come on, the chapter, so not the longer. Muselusi, what am I going to do? Then it means you're not living according to the terms of the covenant. The terms of the covenant, they say that you shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. Huh? The terms of the covenant says that you shall pay your tithe. Huh? Because tithe belongs to who? To God. These are the terms. But you you, what you do is you, when you start eating, not you. When you start eating that diet, then you are not living according to the terms of the covenant. So, child of God, if we are to experience the new beginning, or if we are to experience the increase or the fruitfulness this year, we ought to understand that it is when we get into the terms, or it's when we keep the terms of the covenant, when we can become unstoppable, when we can become undeniable, we are not going to be rejected, we are going to be accepted. Whether we fail to penetrate in 2017, we are going to penetrate. Why? Because we are keeping the terms of the covenant. And when we do that, God takes over our lives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Lord here is saying, 2018 must be a year of entering into new levels, new waters, and establishment in every area. But in order for all this to come to pass, we must make sure that we obey the terms of the covenant without stopping. So, child of God, make a decision today and get committed to the covenant with your God. The only problem has been what did I write here? Has been that we don't want to continue to live according to the terms of the covenant. So the moment we do that, how many things, or the moment we do that, then we cannot see a reality of the fulfillment of those covenant, that covenant in our lives. Now, if we are to see them, how many things did we promise to do for God last year in 2017? How many things did we promise God? So, this year, Lord, I'm going to be committed. Lord, I will do this and this. How many things did we fulfill? Huh? But still fulfill. For the next 6 months, I will be giving 100 kwacha per month. How many of us finished the 6 months? How many of us fulfilled all that we promised God last year? I challenge you this morning, I challenge you this year, that if you promise God to do anything for God this year, child of God, make sure that you walk faithfully. If we are to see, if we are to be successful this year, because the faithfulness is key to your success and a victorious life in 2018. The Lord says, to the faithful, I will show myself faithful. Amen? So my word to you is remain on course. Hallelujah. Okay, briefly, let me just jump to Micah chapter 4. Then we can go on and pray. We praise God. Then I'm sure it will be time now for us to leave the place. Micah chapter number 4 is saying that in the last days, the mountain of God shall become chief of all the mountains. Now, when the Lord is talking about mountains in this scripture, He is simply talking about His church. lesanga mwafalanda pali mountain I mountain marelando lesa alelanda pali imwe eh ebe mwane batile sega mountain alelanda pali imwe tamulebe chef I know we are used in Atreverenga in Mark chapter number 11, where God says, when you have faith, you will say to this mountain, be cast into the sea, move and be cast into the sea, and it shall move. Now that's not the kind of mountain we are talking about here. Now it shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on the top of the mountains. The mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on the top of what? On the top of what? It means that Panotuli, Padema mountains, Ayengi. Padema places, Ayengi, Equivalent, Padema Tukila. You understand that? The way we are, there is a church here, this is a mountain, there is another place there, there are taverns, those are mountains. Are we getting the point?
Amen.
So God is saying, He's going to lift us up above these mountains we see. It means that the people who be coming into this place are more than the people who be going there. But my place is up on the amen, but I agree. I can't hear people agree. Shall we stand? There are few people in the house, in this mountain. But on those mountains, there are a lot. Three of them are in the Now the Lord is saying, you lift up this mountain. This mountain will be on top of those mountains. It means that those mountains won't be seen. What will be seen is this mountain. This year. That's what the Lord is saying. There are so many people who are doing the same business that you are doing. Now the Lord is saying, your business will become on top.
Amen.
Are we getting the point? This is what God is saying. So in short, they say, we end up talking. Allah to sumbula, not evoke his sumbula to you.
Yes.
Are we getting the point?
Yes.
As he does that, as this mountain, which is the house of the Lord, is lifted on high, it means those others will be finally closed.
Amen.
Will be finally
closed.
They are already closed in the spiritual.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Physically. Because no business this year.
Amen.
Wherever capital comes from, we block in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now listen, what is interesting here, the Lord is saying, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on the top of the mountains. the point? Now when everyone sees that light, they will run to it. See what God is saying. He's saying, and this mountain shall be exalted above the hills. In fact, these are not mountains, they are hills. Kayu na mountain na kusana. Mountain shikalamba. Kayu ka no no. Are you getting the point? But now what has been happening when the enemy is also at work? It looks like the kayu kakalamba. Kuchira mountain. Now the Lord is saying in the last days, and these are the last days in which we are right now, where these hills will not be seen anymore. Hallelujah. What is someone here testifying? I don't want to testify. There's a part of my mind that it's not made of my mind. And the peoples shall flow to it. They said the words, Avantu, Vakaya, Kuria Mountain. And this is how God confirmed this word. Let's just confirm my machine. There are people who were told about us. They called back to my phone. Teresa Kumunga and Okwino. On the way for the Yashi. That's this person was our, they were once our neighbors. They used their phone to call. Finally, they located the place. Then we were canceling them. On the 31st of December. Touched up 21 days. That's when we were finishing. Those people. Oh, 28th, sorry. This is 28th or 21th. That's when we finished to talk to those people, pray for them. God confirmed the word. Amen. So if you have been in my chest, fire for your companies, they went to Umbi and the like. That is how people will flow to this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm waiting for evangelists. I want her to come and lead us in prayers. So the Lord is saying, many nations shall come and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways, and we shall walk in his path. For out of Zion the law shall go forth, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem.